This is the Honda 6-speed automatic transmission. This is out of a 2014 Acura RDX. Now, this vehicle had been in a front-end collision, and several portions of the transmission case had actually been broken. And as you can see here, with a aluminum wire feed MIG welder, an attempt at repair had been made, which is actually a satisfactory repair. Here we see the case on this side. It was repaired and then ground off. Now this transmission has come into the shop not really for a transmission problem, but because the flex plate between the engine and the converter had actually broken, and the converter was moving back and forth in the housing. The flex plate actually broke into three separate sections and had almost sheared off completely, and it was making a considerable amount of noise there as the sections of the flex plate were rubbing against the back of the engine, and the converter there was touching the inside of the bell housing. Right now, as we disassemble this transmission for inspection, the first thing we're going to do is go ahead and remove our solenoid valve assembly. Here across the top, these are pulse width modulated solenoids, and here across the bottom, these are on-off solenoids. And here we have a series of pressure switches, which, by the way, these three are all the same. Well, let's go ahead and, using a 10 millimeter, I'll go ahead and disassemble this. Okay, here we've removed the 13 10 millimeter bolts, retaining our solenoid valve body there to the case. Specific special 10 millimeter bolts that are holding on, for instance, our dipstick and bracket, by just simply putting the bolt back in its location just lightly, it stays with the case and I know exactly where it came from. Now we're going to carefully remove the solenoid pack. You're probably going to have to just very, very gently pry to pull it loose. So here we see the solenoid pack, part of the valve body, and here we see our individual distributor tubes. And you'll notice that they all but one have the cup style filters, which of course will be inspected and cleaned. Now, as you can see, I'm going to have to remove these distributor pipes before I actually lift the case off. Here we've removed the four covers there on the back of the case, and we're preparing to remove the case. This cover wouldn't necessarily have had to been removed. This one, though, is very necessary. Here I'm going to be removing the two retaining nuts there on the two shafts. The 12-point nut is actually a left-handed thread, and as you can see, an arrow denotes that. So there, obviously, I would turn it clockwise to loosen, counterclockwise to tighten. This is a conventional right-handed thread. And here, torque with considerable torque and slightly locked, so I'll be using an electric impact to do that. Okay, here we see where the case has been cracked. This is a result of a front-end collision, and the body shop actually did this. They used a aluminum wire MIG welder to actually weld the aluminum. You can see considerable oxidation right there, and then ground it off. Now, it's hard to see in the vehicle, obviously, buried there in the engine compartment, and it does not leak. So they did a satisfactory job. Of course, getting it out of the bench, it's obvious. Okay, now we're going to continue the disassembly of the Honda 6-speed automatic transmission. And as we mentioned, this is out of a 2014 Acura RDX. So we'll go ahead and remove the associated fasteners holding the case halves together, and we'll be removing the nuts, retaining the bearings there to the shafts. And one, of course, is clearly marked with an arrow indicating that that's a left-hand thread. And, of course, this one without a marking is right-hand thread. We'll be using an electric impact for this. There, as we remove the case, we're going to have to squeeze the snap ring in here to release the bearing from the pocket, and we'll be lifting the case straight up. Now, let's go ahead and proceed to remove the corresponding fasteners holding the case halves together. Okay, after removing all of the bell housing bolts and removing the manual linkage, now we want to go ahead and remove the nuts that retain the bearings there to the shafts. Now, the 12-point nut with the arrow, this is the left-hand thread. So here I'm going to go clockwise to actually loosen it. And there we see its washer. The X goes up, and as you can see here, the washer is captured in the splines and require you to pry it loose there with a suitable screwdriver. Be careful, do it evenly. Here we see the conventional right-hand thread, and again it has a similar washer, very different size. The X denotes up.